Hi there, my name is Dr Michael Aicken from Visage Academy. I've just made this short video to show you a way that I teach my students to identify when the tip of their needle is resting on the periosteum versus caught just before the periosteum and resting on soft tissue. Periosteum, which is the surface of bone, has a very similar feel to wood. So for this example, I'm using my guitar, a cheap one, not an expensive one. So this is wood. So first of all, when you put a needle onto wood or onto bone or periosteum, you put the needle down, you wiggle the needle down, it pivots around this very fixed point. That tip of the needle is fixed in that point, right? Because the tip of the needle is embedded. If the tip of the needle is resting on a soft tissue, such as the muscle there overlying the periosteum, we put the needle tip down and we wiggle it, and it's not all the way through. We wiggle it around, it wiggles, it slides around. So it doesn't embed in the periosteum, it slides around. So the difference again, that's stuck in the periosteum, or the that's stuck in the wood, wiggles around. Put it here in the periosteum, it slides around. Why is that important? Well, the reason it's important is because there are some areas, especially the tear troughs and the cheeks, zygomatic arch area. If you're on the bone, then you're underneath all the soft tissue. That means all the soft tissue will slide around over the surface of the bone. If you're not on the bone, you're in the soft tissue, which means that your dermal filler is going to move around with the soft tissue, which is what you usually don't want in those areas, especially the tear trough area, where you want the filler to be in the sooth area, or in the zygomatic arch area, where you want to be augmenting the periosteum of the zygomatic arch.